What's happening, Fish and Friends? Welcome to another episode. Summer is here, it's in full swing. It is hot out, and with hot summer weather comes a little bit different fishing. Early mornings have been key for me. I got a few things in here in this order that are gonna be fun for early mornings. I also got some things that are great for once the sun comes up and those fish move out a little bit deeper and onto cover, things that are great for summer fishing. So I'm gonna take you through what I got, why I got it, and how I plan on using it. So enough talking, let's take a closer look at these. All right, where should we start? Well, I know where I want to start, some frogs. I got a few different frogs. Now, I know I've got a few frogs already. However, a lot of people have said you throw bigger frogs, you get bigger fish to come up. I've kind of had mixed stuff. I've caught larger fish on large frogs and caught smaller fish on large frogs. I don't know, but these are the River to Sea Ishmonro Fat Mat Daddies. They are a larger frog. As you can see, they're 3/4 of an ounce, almost 3 inches long. I'll take one out here to look for you. Now, these also interest me because as a bank angler, oftentimes you're limited to where you can get to. So if you've got a little bit larger, heavier frog that you can throw farther, cast farther, it's just got that many more spots that you can cover and cast to. So I like these. They're a good large profile. They're a big frog. Interesting, they come with a rattle in back. I've never had a frog with a rattle on it. You know, your legs are the standard. I'll definitely trim those down to probably about there, but good looking frog. I've been using those River to Sea Bullywatoo. That's what they are. River to Sea Bullywatoo. I couldn't remember. I was having a brain fart there, but there we go. So it's kind of similar to those, a little bit larger, a little bit bigger profile frog. So I'm excited to try that. White and black are the two most common frogs that I have. I notice I don't deviate from that a ton. So I got a red frog. I know early in the spring, right when that that frog bite's starting to hit off, that generally does well. I don't own any red frogs. I think maybe like one that's black and red, but I'm gonna try that one there. It looks pretty good. So I got three of those. The Jackal Kearas or Kearas. Now these are a smaller frog. As you can see, 2.2 inches there, 1/2 ounce. I'll show you these here too compared. So there's the two frogs side by side. Now it's interesting, this is a 3/4 ounce frog and this is just a little 1/2 ounce frog, but look at the size difference. So I'm excited to throw these larger frogs to see, can we finally call some bigger fish up here in Iowa besides just pound and a halfers? Guarantee you this guy will catch some pound and a halfers, and that's still fine by me. Fishing is fun, and when they're on a frog, I don't care what they are, it's always fun. So I got that chartreuse. I should probably tell you the proper names. This one is called green frog. It's fitting. What's this one called? Brown frog? Are they original? Oh, red frog. There we go, the red frog here. So I also grabbed another red one. I don't have any at all this color, and I like that. The bottom's kind of a translucent gold, yellow, silver with a little bit of an orange chin on it. I like the look of that frog a lot. Good detail. It's good and soft and squishy. Seems like a well-made frog. Hooks are super sharp. Same thing here. I forgot to tell you, that one's good and squishy. Hooks are very sharp. Sticking with the frog theme, I got a bluegill color. I was looking on Tackle Warehouse, and bluegill colors are extremely popular now because pretty much everything was sold out. So I've got a couple of these 13 Fishing Trash Pandas. I've just got a white one and a black one. But I noticed they did have a bluegill color, a bluegill, almost perch color. What do they call this? Well, we're going to call it bluegill or perch color here. Pretty interesting little color. I don't really have anything like this, kind of a creamy yellow bottom. Goes into a brighter yellow. It's got those kind of dark green accents. I think that'll work well as a gold, I almost said goldfish imitation, bluegill imitation. I think that'll work well. Interesting little frog. They work well. The only thing that I'm not quite sure of about on these, I haven't fished them a bunch. I need to fish these more, but when you push it down, there's like extra air stuck in there, so it's almost kind of hard to push it in sometimes. So if a fish comes up and grabs it here, I don't know. It kind of worries me of how the hookup's going to be. I'm a huge fan of when these legs turn up and out of the way. I notice that's kind of hard to move that there. It doesn't really want to move. So I don't know. I haven't tested them a ton. They look good. I like the bottom thing there. I did notice they do not leak water easily, so you don't have to, you know, squeeze it and make the frog pee, you know, push out all the water. But I don't know what the hookup's going to be like. So I'm going to be testing those more. Comment below and let me know if you've used those, the 13 Fishing Trash Pandas. Cool looking frog. Let's see. I thought I had one more frog in here. Yes, I do. One more frog and then some line. I'll go over the line quick. I got some of this. My guy, Tackle Junkie TJ81, if you've not followed Jim and his channel, please do so. He is a very good dude. But he recommended this line specifically. He likes it for frogging. I noticed they had 60 pound, which is kind of unusual. Usually it's like 50, then it jumps up to 65. So I got some of this to try. That was before I was using that Calyx braid that one of you subscribed fishing friends sent to me. And I honestly haven't had any issues with that. I've been using that Calyx all year. It's a very affordable, it's not very expensive braid, and it's been doing well. So I don't know exactly which combo I'm gonna put this on, but I did get some of that, the Sunline FX2 frogging and flipping, 50 pound, 60 pound. I can't read number letters, words well. Okay, and then the last frog I got, the Molex. Now this is one that's designed by Carl. So I'm excited to try this because it's supposed to be a really good walking frog. And what's interesting about this one is I didn't get a frog color, I got silver. I don't have any sort of silver frogs. I kind of got this to mimic baitfish, to be honest, the way it walks. Got a deal there on it, but you can see there it doesn't have two legs, it's just the one deal there. Supposed to mimic baitfish more. Now you can see how much of a longer, where's that other frog? And you can even see there compared to that Ish frog, this is a very tall, long, almost reminds me of that Zoom frog. I haven't thrown that one yet either, but got a number of these I got to test. I'm going to be doing a bunch of frogging, so that's fine by me. I'm happy to test frogs. There we go, silver albino. So we'll see how it does. I'm supposed to walk really well, mimic baitfish more. I'm excited to give that one a try. Okay, I think that's it for the frogs. Let's move on to these. I was so excited to get these. I don't have any of these left. These were my old man's favorite growing up. He threw these religiously, and he was a stud with these, was always catching fish. That's interesting. I just noticed that. Use a weedless wide gap hook. Okay, I've never tried that. If any of you have used one of those hooks on a ribbon tail worm, let me know what you do. Oh, you nose hook it or something? I don't know. I got these for Texas rigs. These are the Berkeley Power Bait worms, specifically both in Tequila Sunrise, my old man's favorite color. I got some of the larger 10-inch worms and some of these 8.5-inch worms. Big, large ribbon tail worms are awesome in the summer when those fish get up tight on cover, the sun comes out, they'll often get nose up right up there on the wood. They don't really want to do anything or move, but when you throw a big meal like this at them, generally they will eat that. The big worm is such a good lure in the summer. So got a couple of those ribbon tail worms specifically in that Tequila Sunrise, just so I can show you all the power of the Tequila Sunrise worms. Back in the day, these were all the rage. Got some more worms in here. I also got a couple other, I don't remember if I got somebody else, but I know I got these. I've never used the Zoom, their Tequila Sunrise version. I've used the old Monster. It's a 10.5-inch worm. Great worm from Zoom. Got those to try out and see how that color does. It's almost more of a purple. I'll show you. That's what it looks like out. Almost more of a like a dark purple maroonish, whereas the Power Bait has like the black mixed in there too. And that's what I'm more, when I think of Tequila Sunrise, like the black, maroon, and then that kind of purple all mixed together. But this is more of just a purple maroon. I like it though. I like it. I like those Zoom old monsters a lot. Caught a lot of fish on those worms. The grape, was it black grape or what is it called? Okay. Oh, speaking of black grape, I also got some of the Zoom old monsters in black grape. What is that color? Hold on, I think I got it back here. I don't know what the name of that color is. Anyway, I also got some of these black grape to try. My old man was throwing those in the Power Bait version. So I got some of these in the Zoom version to try as well, again in that 10.5-inch old monster. Okay, next up is a grande bass. I was looking at large worms and I have never tried this worm of theirs. What do they call this one? The 8-inch Megatail Rattlesnake. This is in the Trophy Hunter color, which I really like. It's like a June bug up top. If we focus, there we go. June bug up top and then like a watermelon red on bottom. So, of course, with the grande bass stuff, they have the ribs on them, which I really like. When you rig these, if you rig these just slightly to the side, so you Texas rig it, instead of putting that hook straight through the middle, rig it just off to the side and your bait will last a lot longer. The nice thing about these is they've got those ribs on there, which helps move the water, kind of catches water, gives it just a little bit different look. You don't see a lot of companies doing that. So that's the Grande Bass Megatail Rattlesnake in that Trophy Hunter color. I like that. Just a different worm, not real big looking, kind of you know, small compared to those other 10.5-inch, but I like that a lot. Oh, I lied to you all. I am so sorry. I did get one more frog, the Scum Frogs. So this one I got in the bluegill color. As I said, I was looking for more bluegill stuff. Not many frogs left in the bluegill color. People have been depleting the bluegill colors at Tackle Warehouse, but I've been having good luck with the Scum Frogs. You're gonna see some videos where I'm using this, catching some bass, a different video where I catch pike. But the Scum Frog works very well. Different than what you see from other companies because there's a big hole in the bottom. You'd think that thing's just going to take on water. It's not going to work very well at all. But it sits kind of butt straight down with the weight here. It sits kind of with the butt straight down and head up. And it just doesn't fill with water. It's a cool design. Now, one thing I've noticed with these, as you can see there, notice those hooks, they're already bent up. So it does have a good hookup ratio. However, if you're throwing this up in and around reeds, around a bunch of wood, you do have to be careful because it does also grab the wood and the reeds as well. So if you're a bank angler, may want to look for something that's a little bit better around the cover, or try bending these down. I haven't tried to do that yet, but in a little bit more open water or where there's not real thick cover, they've already done what I recommend, and that's bend the hooks up just slightly if you can get away with it for a better hookup ratio. And so far, I have had a good hookup ratio on my scum frogs, but just something to be aware of. So that new scum frog, that's the Launch series in that bluegill color. Okay, I saw these. I don't think these are new, but I saw these when I was putting my order in. Now, generally, you all know that the Reaction Innovations Smalley Beaver and Sweet Beaver, those are some of my favorite jig trailers. But in the summer, you know, when the fish's metabolism boosts up, they like a little bit of action, a little bit of fluttery, twittery, dee-dee-dee-dee. So I got these. These are called the Missile Twin Turbos. Essentially just a, you know, a double curly tail grub type thing, but kind of in that that crawfish shape. So I like that. Those will work really well on the back of a jig, and they're a small profile. I thought they'd work well on the back of finesse jigs too. I'm a big fan of those finesse jigs. So I grabbed some of those. That's in the Bruiser, which is like a black and a light blue belly. I like it because it's not real bright, real crazy annoying. It's kind of subtle. So we've got those blue craws around here. That should work well. I got just your regular standard green pumpkin with the black flake. And then I got some white ones. Thought maybe we could even try these on some swim jigs and see how they do. That is called pearl white. So those are the Missile Twin Turbos. I like those. Okay, next up, I did have one more bag of worms, some culprit worms. The other stuff that I was looking at, most everybody out was out of green pumpkin, which makes sense. It's such a good universal color. So I grabbed these. Culprits are good. I threw those a lot back in the day as well. But again, just kind of your standard big ribbon tail worm. They work. They catch fish. Summer months, bass love big worms. So I got some of those 10-inch worms and green pumpkin. Okay, and a couple terminal tackle things just to kind of match the worms. I was out of some EWG hooks, the 5-aught, so I grabbed some of these. I've never used the 6-sense hooks before. These are the Stout Wide Gap. 5-aught's kind of my go-to on those larger worms. I think it fits really well. Yeah, those hooks are super sticky. Look at that. Very sticky hooks, kind of your standard. Do they have the thing here? Okay, they don't have any resin or anything there up at the eye of the hook, but I do notice that it's pushed nice and flush against it there. So that's one thing I always look at too. Some of them, they'll like actually have gaps in there if you get cheap hooks on your line can come out there. So that's just something to think about. But those look good. The 6-sense Stout Wide Gap hooks, some 5-aught. Now the worm hooks, I know with the big worms, you know, some people swear 100% by the worm hooks. I got some of these owners, the Cutting Points, very good hooks. I got a ton of these back when Gander went out of business the first time. And I've pretty much blown through all those, but super good hooks, extremely sharp. I noticed you can see the top of this, I don't know what you call it, the neck, is longer than most regular hooks. So you can see there, let me just show you compared. Like, so you can see how much longer the neck is on this one. And I think that's just to be able to thread more worm up on there instead of, you know, just barely skin hooking it like this. So, you know, normally when you rig a worm, you know, you're just barely taking the hook, putting it in. Just going past there, not a lot. So just almost, you know, quarter of an inch. And that way when you bring it around, your Texas rig looks like that. So I think what the deal is with these is you can bring that down in farther. Like so, you can see I've got more meat there. And I think it's going to be less likely to tear it up. So once you get that pushed all up on there, you can see how much more of the plastic I've got up there by the eye of the hook. So we'll see. I don't know. I just saw them and I thought they looked interesting. I've never used a worm hook like that with a longer neck. Oversized, I got the 7-aught. I think they will fit the worm perfectly well. Large hook like that, I don't have to worry about it messing up the action of it. The action is all in the ribbon tail back here. So 7-aught hook, pretty big, but I don't know. We'll try it. Now to go with those, I grabbed some of these 7-aught hooks. I didn't know they were this big, but wow. Those are the VMC heavy duties. And talk about heavy duty for sure. Yeah, there's not going to be any bending those out. But you can see like on these, let me just show you. The way VMC does this, and I know there's a couple other companies do it, but they have resin all around that. So once you tie your knot up here, it doesn't have a chance to slip out and get out of any little crack like you could potentially have with a hook like this. Now, like I said, 6-sense did a good job of putting that wire real flush up here on the eye of it. But, you know, with one like this, with the resin there, you don't have any sort of chance of that line accidentally coming off or fraying where that
eye of that hook kind of connects together. But yeah, those are definitely large stout hooks, so I don't think we should be bending those. All right, couple other things left in here. Let's just switch gears real quick. I grabbed one of these Jacob Wheeler spinner baits. I liked the look of it. They hadn't been in stock for a minute. I didn't grab a bunch of them because I don't usually throw real big spinner baits, and they were completely out of 3/8 and everything. So I grabbed a 1/2 ounce for when I'm out on the boat, maybe if I'm doing some ledge fishing over some grass. We'll see how that does this summer, but it's a good looking spinnerbait. I like the profile of it. A little bit larger blades for a little bit more thump. It does not have a soft plastic keeper, so I guess I'll be running this dude naked. Probably throw a trailer hook on there. Anytime the skirt and those blades come way out here past the bend of that hook, I personally like to run a trailer hook if I can get away with it. But, you know, just kind of your standard looking spinnerbait there. Jacob Wheeler is an absolute stud. Maybe if I buy this, I'll have 1/1000th of how successful he is, and I'd be a whole lot better than I am now. So that Jacob Wheeler River Special, I like that. I got some of these VibraShaft spinnerbaits. They had these on sale. I think they were like $3 or something like that. The original VibraShaft, I remember these. I remember hearing about these. They're Stanley, but I couldn't tell you the last time I had or used one. So I figured for $3 or $4, whatever they were, I grabbed a couple 3/8 ounce. That's usually my go-to. Got a couple in white color, and then one in, what is that? Sexy Shad Chartreuse. I like it in dirty water. I like to have a little bit of a flash. Oh, and I like that they have that flash boost stuff in there too. So some VibraShaft spinnerbaits. We are almost to the end of it here. They had these on sale. These are those Antidote Glides from Bait Sanity. I've got one in the bread color. I've thrown it. I honestly, I don't know what to think about swim baits. It's fun. I've been throwing them, but I can't get fish to actually dedicate and eat the thing. I need to spend a whole day fishing these and not, you know, fart around throwing the frog for most of the day. Then I'll kind of throw a swim bait for an hour or so and then go back. I've got a bad habit of doing that. I need to go out with only these one day and try to catch some. But that's in that trout color, super slow sink. I really like that Bait Sanity. If you're looking for a bait with a good action, it runs really well right out of the package. I haven't had to do anything with them. That Bait Sanity Antidote Glide. Okay, next I grabbed a smaller little glide bait. This is the G-Rat Pistol Pete. I have one more of these. I should say had one more of these that I lost. That's the game you play when you fish large swim baits, or in this case, kind of large swim baits. But this is 5.75 inches, 1.2 ounces, 5.75 inches. That's that smaller Pistol Pete. So you can see the size of those compared to each other like that, that larger Bait Sanity and that smaller Pistol Pete. So I figured I'm going to try this, see if I can get some fish to commit. Maybe it won't have the drawing power as the large swim baits, but for some of the ponds and stuff around here, maybe I can get a bunch of, you know, 2-pounders and stuff to commit just to kind of get used to that glide bait bite. But we'll see how it does. G-Rat Pistol Pete. Okay, and last but not least in here, I'd get another swim bait. Now these they had on sale. I think they were like $12 or something when I got it. This came a while ago. I just haven't got around to unboxing and doing it. But this is a little 5-inch glide. So again, I thought, you know, maybe I can get a smaller little swim bait glide deal. I'd never heard of these. For the price, I figured, why not? Let's try it. Looks kind of almost like an S-Waver, River CS Waver. Pretty translucent color. It's got kind of a blue pearl shimmer to it with just a regular white belly and a little chartreuse dot there. Comes ready to go. I don't know. It's got a soft tail on it, so I'm hoping that gives it a little bit of action back there when it's going through the water. Standard glide bait. I just got to work them. I got to work them more and throw them. Dedicate time. That Jerry Rago Cha-Cha Glide.
All right, fishing friends. That does it for today's video. Comment below and let me know what you're the most excited to see me throw. I'm personally excited to throw these big, huge-ish fat daddy frogs. They say the bigger the frog, the bigger fish gonna call up. So I'm excited to try that. And also this Kayara frog, a little bit smaller frog for when that bite is tough, a little bit more finicky bass. See how that one does. And honestly, I know these are gonna perform, but I still can't wait to use them. My pops' favorite, Tequila Sunrise Power Bait Worms. I mean, he's thrown these for so long, they work, they flat out work. So comment below and let me know what you are most excited to see. So tonight's subscribe fishing friend shout out goes to Razel Paguara. Hopefully I pronounced that right. Thank you, sir, for watching the videos and chatting back and forth. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have found those whopper ploppers. So thank you everybody else that watches my vids. I am, like I said, blown away. I can't believe my channel's done this well. So thank you all so very much for watching. It's late and I gotta get to editing. So thanks for watching, and until next time,